In this video, we're given a definite integral, so the integral from 0 to 1/4 of tangent pi x, and I'm going to approach it in two different ways. I call them the informal approach and the formal approach. And the essence of the informal approach is, can I recognize the chain rule backwards and guess the antiderivative? In the formal approach, we'll be making formal u-substitutions. So for the integral of a tangent function, the way forward is to express that as a sine over a cosine. And now I recognize that I have 1 over a function, that's the cosine pi x, multiplied by the derivative of that function. This looks like the chain rule operating on the natural log of the cosine. There are some adjustments to make, of course, because the derivative of cosine pi x is negative sine pi x multiplied by pi, just using the chain rule there to get the derivative of cosine pi x. So I just tacked on a negative pi to that numerator in order to force it to be exactly the derivative of the denominator. I need to put a negative 1 over pi out in front to compensate for changing it by a constant multiple in the interior. All right, anytime I have 1 over a thing multiplied by its derivative, I recognize that as the chain rule operating on that expression in the denominator. And I still need to evaluate this across the limits of integration. So I have negative 1 over pi times natural log of the absolute value of pi over 4 for the upper limit. I don't need the absolute value signs because the cosine of pi over 4 is a positive thing. Then I get minus natural log cosine of 0, which is 1, so minus natural log of 1. Again, the absolute value bars don't matter once I realize that I have a positive thing in there. And the natural log of 1 is 0, so that's gone. So I just need to plug in what's the cosine of pi over 4, and you can write that as 1 over root 2, or you could write it as root 2 over 2. I think I'm going to choose 1 over root 2. And the reason I chose the 1 over root 2 here is because I want to take advantage of some log properties. So 1 over root 2 could be written as 2 to the negative 1/2. And I can move that power of negative 1/2 out in front. And the minus signs are going to cancel, and I end up with a 1 over 2 pi natural log 2. In my most formal approach to this problem, I actually have to do multiple substitutions. So the way I'm going to start is by saying, I don't like this somewhat complicated interior function pi x. I want to replace that with a single letter u. So I'm going to say let u equal pi x. That means du is pi dx. I'm also going to transform the limits of integration so I don't have to think about x anymore. And I say when x is 0, it means u is pi times 0, which is also 0. And when x is 1/4, it means u is pi over 4. So I transform my integral. And to deal with the differential piece, well, du was pi dx. So I can throw a pi into the interior of the integral, provided I divide it out in front. And I get pi dx, which is du. So I have 1 over pi times this integral tangent u du. Now I'm still wondering, how do I integrate the tangent function? And the solution is really the same idea from before. I've got to write it in terms of sine and cosine. When I have something that looks like the derivative of the denominator sitting in the numerator, it has to come from the natural log of that denominator. And so still having an inkling of what the chain rule is doing backwards motivates my next substitution. I want to have a name for cosine u. I'm going to call that v. And dv is going to be negative sine u du, taking the derivative there. And when u is 0, v is the cosine of 0, which is 1. And when u is pi over 4, v is the cosine of pi over 4, which is 1 over root 2. Then in my integrand, I have to tweak things a little bit because I need negative sine u du. So I've got to throw that minus sign in the interior and then multiply by negative 1 in the exterior. And I can rewrite my integral in terms of v. So I have negative 1 over pi. Integral as v goes from 1 to 1 over root 2. And then negative sine u du, that's dv. And then cosine u, that's v. And now I recognize that base formula for the thing that I integrate to get the natural log of the denominator. And I get natural log absolute value v, and I'm evaluating from 1 to 1 over root 2, and the absolute value bars are unnecessary because both those limits of integration are positive numbers, and I have negative 1 over pi, natural log 1 over root 2, minus natural log 1, which vanishes. And again, 1 over root 2 is 2 to the negative 1 half, and I pull the power out in front, and I end up with 1 over 2 pi natural log 2. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.